Hey everyone, Kyle Meinke here from MLive.com, joined by Justin Rogers. We just spoke to Jim Caldwell for about 20 minutes or so, and it definitely felt like the Lions lost to the Green Bay Packers, not won 19-7. Two big items of note with the Lions: they've released place kicker Nate Freese, and they'll be signing Alex Henry to replace him, former Eagles kicker, and they've also they intend to play Stephen Tulloch on IR with a torn ACL as a result of his sack celebration and subsequent ACL injury. What's your reaction to the Tulloch injury?
It's huge. I mean, sometimes you just count on a guy to be there, and Tulloch's one of those guys. He's played in 130 plus straight games.
131.
Yeah. He was the NFL's leading Ironman. A lot of those were starts. I think he was a backup early in his career, but basically it started 6-7 straight years, and you just expect Stephen Tulloch to be the rock of the middle of that defense. Great run defender,
great tackler,
all over the field, and he's going to be really tough to replace. You know, Jim Caldwell wouldn't commit to moving DeAndre Levy to the middle today, but I think that's the logical solution. Levy played there early in his career. He's got the intelligence to be the leader of the defense and step up in that role, but that leaves a void on the outside to hear Whitehead can step in there immediately. But, you know, you still have another spot on the outside, which is either a nickel or a linebacker, where they're just down everybody, and probably going to bring in a linebacker off the street, but
yeah. DeAndre Levy showed against the Packers that he has the versatility and the know-how and the ability to play middle, but I know the Lions like him on the weak side. He's great there. He's one of the best. He's becoming one of the best in the NFL because of what he can do. We saw him against Green Bay. We saw him in the backfield bringing down Eddie Lacy for a safety. We also saw him back in coverage and playing well there. He's one of the best coverage linebackers in the NFL. So the Lions like what he can provide, the versatility at the weak side. They might want to try to keep him there and play Tahir or a assigned guy in the middle. Or he played well enough to pull off the move to the middle, and they could put Tahir Whitehead at the weak side. Those seem to be the two options for the Lions at this point.
You know, I like Levy in the middle. I think it gives him more versatility. The one maybe negative in Tulloch's game is his pass coverage. Your middle linebacker you could do anything with, and with Levy's skill set being as versatile as it is, you know, I think he'd be in the middle if Tulloch wasn't here in the first place. But, you know, Tulloch's a good player. They weren't going to get rid of him. Now it gives him, Austin, that versatility to drop him into coverage, drop him in deep zones like a Tampa 2 type look. The blitzing that Tulloch does, Levy's capable of doing that. We've seen him get into the backfield many times this season already. It's just a natural fit, but it leaves them, you know, short on the outside until Van Noy gets back, which I think, week 9?
Right, week 9. Well, week 10, actually, because the bye was in week 9. But yeah. It's just another blow for a defense that's already sustained several injuries, which we've enumerated several times. But with Van Noy hasn't played yet. Bill Bentley's out for the season. Nevin Lawson's out for the season. Cassius Vaughn didn't play last week. On and on and down the line. And, you know, to sustain an injury to the captain of your defense, captain from last year, he's captain week 1 this year, all those starts consecutively, as you mentioned, the play caller of the defense, it's a big blow. It's really a blow for the defense. They're even thinner now at linebacker, and I've seen a lot of people. It's really unfortunate the way it occurred, obviously, in a celebration, and I've seen a lot of people, especially fans, questioning the celebration and saying things like "see," whatever they're saying. But I mean, Caldwell made a good point about this. He's saying that the guys are enthusiastic, and you have to let them have their enthusiasm for the game because that's why they're all here. They love to play, and when you make a play, if you get a sack, every guy is going to celebrate. If you score a touchdown, every guy is going to celebrate. That's a natural part of the game, and it's unfortunate that Tulloch suffered this fluke injury, but it's a fluke, and there's really nothing you can do to prevent something like this.
I have zero problem with it. You know, it's a violent game. We reward big hits. They're celebrated. These guys are putting their careers on the line essentially every single snap. And the celebration he did, it wasn't like he did a backflip or something. He did a small leap, like an explosion move, and freak injury. It could have happened before the play, and maybe that was the straw that broke the camel's back. Maybe it happened on celebration. Doesn't matter. You don't take that away from players that are playing in a really emotional game or where emotions play a high level or role in the game.
Yeah. Second big move for the Lions today was the move with Nate Freese, and it's really a quandary. You and I were just talking off camera about this, but how a guy can go from being so good at Boston College, he was 20 for 20 last year, going through the audition process and in the draft, being good enough to be drafted as a specialist, to come in and to look so shaky almost from the start, real bad early in training camp, seemed to start improving, and then once the season hit, just lost his leg again. And 3 out of 7, you knew this move was coming after he missed that 41-yarder against the Packers.
There's no other way to say it than it was between the ears. You know, it was a mental thing. We know he has the physical capabilities to be a good kicker in this league. We saw the distance with the 55-yarder during the preseason with plenty of leg. We've seen him in practice make them in the 60-yard range. His accuracy was great in college, but you know, it was kind of like a slippery slope since from the day he got here. It's not like the turf is strange. I mean, he was kicking indoors in a nice environment most of the time. It just once that ball started rolling downhill, he couldn't gather it back in.
Every time I talked to Nate Freese, I came away with the impression of a guy who struggled with the mental makeup of being an NFL kicker. I don't want to say he'll never pan out for any team ever in the NFL, but that was just my impression that this guy had a problem putting the last kick behind him, which is something you need as a kicker, because you need to make almost every one, and when you do miss one, you need to make the next one, and things always seem to snowball for him, and I just don't know if he quite had the ability to play this game, to play that position between the years.
You know, I haven't been a reporter long enough or been around enough kickers to really make the correlation. I've been around Jason Hansen, David Akers, and Tevecchio, and their personality, at least when they're actually with us, is they were always so bubbly, vivacious. They were able to interact with the media with ease, and just confidence exuded from their personalities in every facet. And Freese didn't have that. You know, it was more of a nervous quality about him.
He always seemed nervous.
And I just wonder if you know, the two correlate at all. I mean, you were around some kickers at Michigan. I don't know if you got the same vibe with confidence off the field, on the field, but Freese just didn't seem to have it, and who knows? You know, maybe it'll work out for him down the road, but it won't be here.
Yeah. The guy the Lions brought in to replace him, Alex Henry, very good in college at Nebraska. He's a former teammate of Ndamukong Suh's there, left as the school's all-time leader in scoring. He's actually the NCAA all-time leader in field goal percentage at 89% plus. And so he's got an accurate leg, was drafted in the 4th round by the Eagles, so this guy's got a serious leg. Was a kicker there for a couple of years in 11 and 12, and was very good, 85% plus both years. Struggled a little bit more last year, and had some major issues in training camp apparently this year, 1 out of 3 in the preseason, and was cut, and that's why he was available for the Lions. Tough to tell what we'll get from him, but it seemed like great leg, but had some problems in camp. Sounds kind of familiar with Nate Freese, but this guy at least has a track record in the NFL.
Yeah, he's an 86% field goal kicker in the NFL. I mean, you're talking like top 10 accuracy all time if he sustained that over a career. You know, I looked back at his season last year. He had 6 misses, including one in the playoffs. Almost all of them were for beyond 45 yards. There was a 39-yarder he missed in Green Bay where the wind got it. You know, even still with those misses, he made over 80% of his field goals last year. You know, I think it's a good pickup. He was the best available option out there.
The Lions are 2-1. I have to feel pretty good about that, but certainly there are injury issues afoot that still continue to plague this team. Most recently with Stephen Tulloch, we didn't even get to the offensive side of the ball and right tackle. So just a lot of issues with this team, and then of course the kicker situation. So something certainly to watch as this team tries to turn the page to the Jets this week. For Justin Rogers, I'm Kyle Meinke. We are M Live. Keep it right here.